What is going on, you guys? This is Erica's for the Win, back with another Elden Ring video. Can you guys believe it? We're about 2 months away from Elden Ring's release. So what better way to celebrate than talk about the great Miyazaki? He's in the news lately because he's talked to Edge magazine. They interviewed him and he talked about why he will not play Elden Ring. And his reasons are very interesting, and I could understand where he's coming from because he built this game, right? He did a lot for this game, and for him, it's not a fresh experience. He's such a mastermind. He's over here just making masterpieces and then walking away, dropping the mic. You guys got it, he says, because he's already seen it. He's already done everything, and he, I guess, doesn't play the games once he's done, and this is kind of his policy. And this is all very fitting because he talks about the open world and how it enriches the experience. And I just made a video, my last Elden Ring video, trying to ease the minds of those who are hesitant or a little bit intimidated by Elden Ring. And a lot of it had to do with the open world. So it's very nice to hear from him that the open world is such a big factor in this game. Let's go ahead and read this quote. He says here, "You know, I probably won't end up playing Elden Ring because it's a game I've made myself. This is sort of a personal policy. You wouldn't get any of the unknowns that a fresh player is going to experience. Like I said before, it wouldn't feel like playing. But if I did, then this would be close to the ideal game I'd want. I don't approach it in the terms of this is the kind of open world game I want to make. It's just that the open world enriches this ideal experience I'm trying to achieve." Man, that sounds so good. I love when he puts it this way. To give some very simple examples, if I were to explore the world, I'd want a map, a proper map, or, you know, if I saw something over there, I'd want to actually be able to go over there and explore it. Yes. Yes, a million times yes. This is what we want as well. At least this is what I want. I love the idea of just looking at my surroundings and just far off stuff in the distance that I could go explore. And I know that I can go over there and check it out. That's just such a great freedom that a lot of games don't have. He also says, "And I'd want to fight with a dragon in an epic arena." Oh, Miyazaki, you're killing me, man. I love everything about this. I could frame this paragraph. I really could. "Things like this," he says, "it's very simple stuff, but Elden Ring allows a lot of these things to become a reality for me, creating something that's very close to my ideal game." So there he goes saying beautiful things, the open world enriching the experience, being able to go and explore where you want, fighting with dragons and epic arenas. I mean, does it get any better than that? We've seen the trailers, we've seen the network test gameplay, we've played it if we were fortunate, and we know that there's gonna be amazing things that we're getting into. It's just so nice to hear it from him, you know, that he sees it that way. And that's what he's presenting for us, and it just all comes together. He also goes on to say that we wanted to create this world that was full of joy, of exploration of the unknown. So we wanted to create lots of enticing things for the budding adventure. And we wanted to prepare lots of these mysterious situations that players would read about or hear about and want to go looking for and want to go exploring. Variety is something we strive for when creating this game, and something I believe we've managed to achieve. Mic drop. Just, that's it. That's all you gotta say. It's so beautiful. So beautiful. So I like how he says, there's a lot of mysterious situations that players would read about or hear about. So I wonder if he's saying for this game in particular, like there's gonna be these things we hear about. Maybe you're gonna see something that I don't, and I'm gonna hear about it, and then I'm gonna go looking for it. That just sounds amazing. So this was a great interview, a great couple of answers he gave here. And that's all it really was in this article. They did talk about how there's no rings in Elden Ring. That could be its own topic. I think that's interesting as well. There's gonna be talismans in the game instead, I believe, and there's reasons for it. So yeah, if you're a big fan of rings in Souls-like games and From Software games, you're probably gonna be a little disappointed, but there's gonna be its own system when it comes to those types of perks and stuff you get with the rings here in Elden Ring, which is pretty cool. So we're gonna have a nice substitute. I wouldn't worry too much about that. Another thing that was a part of this article that I was reading about this interview is that they mentioned the mounted combat will not be enforced on its players of Elden Ring. So it just goes to show even more so that there is freedom of choice. If you want to use the mounted combat, you can, or you could not use it if you don't want to. So it just shows further that yes, we have that option and there's freedom to Elden Ring, and it's just another strategy among many, like it says here, and that's pretty awesome. So just a reminder for everyone. That's pretty much it for this article though. I hope you enjoyed my thoughts on it. It's gonna be an amazing game, you guys. It's sounding so epic. It's sounding like a phenomenon. Game of the year 2022. Book it already. It's a wrap. I feel bad for the other games. Shout out to them. Nah, but in all seriousness, you guys, this was awesome to read. I wanted to give my thoughts on it. Miyazaki, he's out here just doing his thing, and then he walks away and he's gonna go do another thing. That's just how great he is. He's so good. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about Miyazaki and what he said, and if this makes you feel more excited for Elden Ring, let me know. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.